Hey, welcome back. In this video, I take you through the quest of me purchasing a pressure washer for my car. And this is a journey which I want to take you through and tell you what's best, what is important when you're buying a pressure washer. And I hope this video helps you. I kept this video very simple. I've showed you a few points to consider and the final decision was made and I purchased one of these. So let's go through the video. Stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching rTech. Just like everybody else, I use Google to kind of search and find out what is the best pressure washer you should get for yourself in case you're getting one. I'm sure these things are going to be kept for a long time, so it's better you buy a good quality one rather than, you know, save a little bit of money here. So there are two types, induction motor based as well as universal motor based pressure washers. The research has shown that the induction motors are much better, more superior, and they do have a few cons as well, but here's what I managed to put across for you guys. So they last longer, they consume less power, make less noise, easy to repair, and the cost is a little higher initially. Cons for induction motors, they're heavy and they have slightly lower torque at the beginning, which really wouldn't make a difference for us. So immediately I changed my search to pressure washer with an induction motor. I got plenty of options and you have to be careful here because sometimes they don't offer you one with an induction motor. So you make sure that the machine you get has an induction motor. So finally settled on the STARQ’S W3A. This is a small domestic pressure washer. Let me show you how it looks inside. So the box has a few cards inside, multi-language displays, and it's packed very well, the two boxes and nice straps around them. So 2100 watts, 22 bar maximum pressure. On the website, it shows 150 bars, so it looks like it varies between 150 to 220 max. So let's open up this. Before that, let me just show you the box. You have all the accessories here, which they mentioned. It's got a built-in pressure gauge, of course. There is a pressure gun and some small accessories, which you can also use additionally if you want to buy it separately. So yeah, this is a self-priming pump-based pressure washer, so you can use it with a bucket of water rather than running water. There is a hose when you open up the box. So this is for you to probably drop it into a bucket of water or fix it to a tap. So this is not very long, maybe about 1.5–2 meters. This is the pressure gun, very small in size. You can use an extension for this if you want to, and you will need to purchase that separately. So yeah, this has got a reading which says 150 bar pressure max. So it's got a small lock as well, and it looks like the parts made of brass where you connect the hose. And of course, this is adjustable. And the build quality seems pretty decent. So there's some thermocol protection. Inside, I found that you straight away get to the pressure washer, and you can see the black hose. That's a water hose inside. And it's nicely packed, all of this. So there is a nice bag which holds all of your accessories along with your manual, I'm guessing. So yeah, this is the foam washing accessory, which I'll show you how it works later. And this is a filter which you drop into your bucket along with the hose for the inlet. This is one of those connectors which connects the whole hose to your inlet socket on your pressure washer. And this is, again, another accessory for you to connect your hose. The manual looks pretty basic, just a paper manual. And there's a warranty card in case you probably buy it out the store. So if you buy it on Amazon, it should be fine. So this is the hose. And it looks like it's made of pretty good material because there seems to be some sort of metal casing. And the ends are actually all metal. So there is a metal screw cap as well to kind of secure this to your pump as well as your gun. Hose length is about 8 meters. So that's about 24 feet, 25 feet approximately. And that's the final thing in the box, your pressure washer. It's very small. It's probably the size of maybe 2 iron boxes. Yeah, and most of the pressure washers come in the same design. I'm guessing they just probably relabel it and sell it. So there is a pressure gauge at the end of every of these pressure washers. I'm not really sure how useful it is for someone, but yeah, I'm just a novice user, so let's see how it goes. So this is an all-round view of this device. So you have input and external sockets there on both sides. There's a small pressure gauge. There is a bubble, air bubble on all these pressure gauges, so nothing to worry about. That's how it's going to be. This is your output on one of the sides. There's a small power button, which is also protected with plastic. This device is not water resistant. You can see the inconsistency here. It says 120 to 180 bar, but on the box it says 220 max. So everywhere it's different. And now the power plug here. This is using a German plug, so which means there's no earthing option when you use it on a regular 220 volt socket. So you have to be careful about this. So if you want earthing, you'll have to use a socket which is specific to this particular plug or change the plug itself. So that's my recommendation. And overall, it looks like the power cord is about 2 meters. And this is what you get, your foam cannon box, user manual with some cards, some filters, some accessories to fix your hoses, the gun, of course. And that's what you get in the box. So as I mentioned, you need to connect some of these accessories together to kind of make it work. So this is for your input connector. So this connects to a releasable plug, which is basically fixed to your pressure pump. So this one will actually ensure that you can easily release this off once you finish using it. And it's a very simple mechanism. Right. So we'll do that a little later. And obviously the other end has a small filter. In case it starts pulling anything else from your bucket, it will prevent that. And the hose. So this looks like it's got some sort of metal casing outside, and the pressure gun is going to fix with that. And your input is going to be on the left and the output's going to be on the right side. Just trying to access. Okay, so this is the pressure foam cannon, which you can use along with this device. Now, I've seen this in videos. I haven't done this before, but this looks a little small in terms of an accessory, and it actually fits directly to your pressure gun. And of course, we'll see how it works a little later. So I have made some basic connections here. So this unit is plugged in, I've switched it on, and you can see that the pressure has actually gone to about 220 straight away. So the hose is connected, like I mentioned, it goes on the right side of the device, and the water is obviously pulled in from the left side through the input connector. And this uses something called as a Venturi system, which means the moment you start putting this on, it builds up some pressure inside the device, and that itself acts like a switch. So my dad's actually helping me do this, so that's the input connector which is in the bucket. I'm just going to use one bucket of water just to test it initially.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a lot of noise and it seems to be working great. So just did a little bit of test cleaning here. We sprayed this. So you can actually adjust this in different sections. Obviously, you can have a flat output or you can have a sharp output. You can use it carefully because these things are very dangerous. So when I'm using it on the paint itself, you got to be very careful not to use the, you know, piercing option, which can probably damage paint. So this here is useful to probably remove really hard muck or whatever else you have, probably inside your tires and stuff like that. But never use this particular mode on your paint directly. Let me know what you guys think about this machine so far. If you're liking this video, please hit the like button and do subscribe. So yeah, that's pretty easily adjustable, and this gun is so small, so anyone can actually use it easily. And this particular mode here is probably suitable for your paint. I think anything more than this will be causing damage. And this is really powerful. It's around 150, at least 150 to 200 bar. I mean, the machine's showing about 220 there, so I'm guessing the output will be at least 150. Here's a little bit of test wash. and seems to be doing a decent job. So this is without the foam cannon. I mean, that is something I haven't tried. So I am going to fail at that for sure. But we'll keep that a second moment. And the best part is the auto switch off. The moment you release the pressure, the trigger on the gun, the system goes off, which is really nice. I mean, it's really convenient. Single-handed operation is very easily possible. And here's the foam cannon failure. So basically it works fine. It's just that I didn't make a solution of this correctly. The proportions were not right, so it's a little too watery. But it still worked, and I was pretty happy with the wash. So yeah, that's how not to do it correctly. So make sure that you take the right measurements before making this foam cannon solution. But either ways, it seemed to be working well. I just felt that the accessory was a little too small, but otherwise it's fine. At a closer look, you could actually see that it was doing a good job in terms of loosening some of the dirt. And it's advisable to first use the foam rather than wash the car first. So yeah, once you do that, of course, you can play with the pressure gun, and with this flat output, it does a good job of cleaning off whatever dirt is remaining. So yeah, this particular device, this particular machine, uses about 7 liters per minute. So that's the amount of water it's going to use. So if you have a bucket which is about 20 liters, it'll take about 4 to 5 minutes to completely drain out one bucket. So it's not bad. Honestly speaking, if you use a regular bucket of water, it's going to use more water than using a spray pressure gun like this. So I'm guessing it's the same concept of using a shower at home rather than a bucket of water. And the results were awesome. Even though I failed at making a proper foam spray on this one, the results were good. And remember, you'll always have to use a brush on your wheels, even though you use the foam cannon, because it doesn't clear off the tough stains on the wheels. So do give it a brush, even though I think the paint is fine. Anything on the body of the car is fine. But the wheels and the lower half of the body, you got to just give it a slight brush after using the foam, because it will loosen up the dirt easily. So stick to an induction motor. That's the W3A from STARQ’S. I think it's a pretty handy pressure washer. Hope you liked the video. Please hit the like button, subscribe, stay tuned for more such videos. Links in the description if you want to buy this. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.